Holly Holm. Hi. Gracious enough to join us. Congratulations on a big win.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay, I have to ask this because you had the headset on and Jermaine said maybe the winner of tonight's main event will fight me next.
Hey, you never know. That could be a rematch we're looking forward to. Who knows? You know, I always just train. That's what I do, and I have a great team around me to kind of help put that together. So we'll see what happens in the future.
How would you describe how those five rounds went for you?
You know, I felt in control the whole time. I mean, no fight is really 100% in your control, right, because anything can happen. But I felt like I was kind of controlling the fight. But I just didn't want to get caught with something stupid. I wanted to stick to the game plan. And there's always a million other things that I wish I would have done even better, you know. But I'm always a work in progress, and that's why I'm still doing this sport, you know.
Do you think it's fair to say that we saw some real developments in you wrestling today? I mean, really chaining things together to get these takedowns finished?
I work on it all the time, but as far as it coming together in a fight, you know, you work hours and hours and hours for 15 minutes or 25 minutes. And so sometimes I feel like, oh, I wanted to show this and that, and there's so many things that I think, man, when I was on the ground, I should have done this or I should have done that. But, you know, it's also your offense against them, and it's offense and defense 100% of the time for the whole fight. You know, I think that's one of the things that makes fighting so exciting is it's really unpredictable because you're working on – it's not like something where you just go out and do a performance. You know, you're trying to do your performance while they're also, you know, trying to take your head off, so –
You've competed at the top of this division for a long time, and obviously there's some other veterans that you can match up with, but this was the new blood kind of coming to steal your thunder. How did that dynamic play into your motivation?
Well, a lot of people keep talking about, you know, when I'm going to retire because I'm old, you know, I'm like going to be...
We're not old, Holly.
I know I'm not. Yeah. I'm saying this is what people say.
No, right. we don't listen to them.
I'll be 39 in a couple of weeks, and I feel just as... young and healthy. I mean, injuries could probably stick around a little longer than they did when I was 20. But other than that, I feel strong, stronger than I did then. I feel more knowledgeable, and I still feel hungry. And, you know, when I was in boxing, there was kind of like, when I first got into boxing, there was like the top 10, and they kind of like filtered through, and then there was like a whole new wave. And I feel like that's the same in MMA. And, you know, maybe I'll be a grandma still out here doing this stuff, so I don't know.
How much do you feel experience played a part in the fight tonight?
You know, I think each fight is just its own. I mean, I know she's had a lot of experience before even coming into MMA, and I just think, I mean, I've probably gone more five-round fights than her.
But 8 of 12 you've been matched for. I checked yesterday.
I'm glad you checked because I was thinking how many times, after round three, I was like, man, the fight would be over right now. I was like, but, and a lot of times people are like, oh, well, we want to wait till we can get like, you know, we should get like 5 round fights for you. Because, you know, your conditioning is usually good. I'm like, yeah, but that also means it won't work for me too.
Can you talk about what happened at the end of the fight? Because in the fifth round, you could have just kind of got on your bike and coasted to a victory, but you really turned it up and you kind of moved forward into kind of a brawl for the last 30 seconds.
I guess I just still had some left in there, and it is a fight, and sometimes you just got to let the dog out a little bit, you know. I knew she was kind of hurt, and I guess maybe I was just hoping to get a finish.
Yeah.
Was there a reason you kept circling in the same direction? Were you trying to walk her onto that head kick? Because that was kind of what it was feeling like.
You know what? She was fighting a lot for that outside angle. It's a righty-lefty game, and I knew what she was trying to do, so I was just making sure to not let her capitalize on it. So that was kind of just a lot of her offense. She was trying to get to that angle, but, you know, that's the name of the game. You got to be able to fight from each side of that angle. That's what everybody tries to do, lefty-righty. They want to get to that outside angle, but... you know, I didn't feel too threatened with her being there, so I kind of let her kind of feel like she was comfortable, and I would go when I would want to go.
So you'll get on a plane later today. How would you describe your experience on Fight Island?
It's definitely been an experience. So different, you know. I've never lived in a bubble before.
Right, I know, right?
It's like food's here, fun's here.
Yeah.
Your team's here. And you're just going to stay here?
Some pretty good cardio outside. Some pretty good cutting weight weather, right?
Yeah, you know what? I've never been on a fight trip where it's like, hey, just run in the middle of the street because there's no traffic.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Okay, I'll do that. And a little beach was nice. You know, it's been an experience. And it's been a time that I've really got to kind of bond with my team, you know, because there's really not a lot outside of this little bubble out here. But I don't really do a lot of fight week anyway. It's just rest and focus and maybe joke around with the team a little bit to keep it light. But it's been an experience. And I don't know, it's my third time coming overseas to fight, so sometimes it's like, it's one of those things, man, especially this one. There's a lot of extra time to come out to this fight. We leave almost a week earlier than normal, and to take them away from their family and, hey, guys at home, I know I took all the coaches with me, but I know you can hold down the fort for a little while, but I didn't want to come all this way and not make it worth it, you know?
Melbourne, Australia, and Singapore, and now here,
and
overseas
now
is the key.
I know.
Right?
I guess it's the way to do it, you know.
Some of your best performances of your career. So what's next for you?
You know, I think I'm going to just enjoy whatever time we have right here before we go to the plane and enjoy the flight back. And I can't wait to go see everybody at home and hug them.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.